I'm David Maudsley, and today we're going to be interviewing the most prominent people related to the speech and debate team, along with a few people who qualified for nationals.
Okay. What are you most excited about for nationals?
Being back in person. The last 2 years it's been virtual, and so the students are really excited about going back because it's about a week, hotel, the travel, the bonding, the competition, and we'll have some recognition this year for senior Sabrina Richard, who is the first Westfield four-time qualifier, qualified every year since freshman year.
What are you most excited for about nationals?
Competing in storytelling. Everybody loves a good story, and I like being the storyteller.
All right.
I'm excited to get recognized, and I'm excited to... We made it a goal the first year that we went, because the past 2 years it's been virtual. We made it a goal to meet someone from all 50 states. So I think I kind of want to do that again, because it was a lot of fun to like look around and be like, who here is from Alaska? And then as well as our teacher, our coach, is getting recognized, Miss Ryan King, for earning her diamond, which is 15,000 points.
What is the thing that makes you most proud about your students?
The ones that really just have a strong work ethic and then really want to help others and work with them too. It's really neat to see them try to pass on their traditions and make sure they continue when they graduate.
We would like to congratulate the three people qualifying for nationals, which are Sabrina, Elizabeth, and Mary. We'd also like to congratulate Miss Raina King and Sabrina for getting recognized.
And the art hallway doesn't just have paintings, it has sculptures and wire pieces as well. Here we have Clara Keurig, who created this amazing little duck swan clay pot, as well as this adorable little octopus. I genuinely love the texture, the creativity, overall, very good work. And here we have another sculpture piece from Sculpture One by Elise Kramer. I'm assuming it's a mole of some kind, maybe a beaver skull, but she did a fantastic job replicating it with wire, and I honestly love how it genuinely looks just like the real thing. All right, and here we have pieces from Sculpture One. This piece specifically, Leia Rayner's sculpture, stuck out to me just because I watched Coraline when I was little, and I could clearly tell with how much detail she put into it that it was from Coraline, or at least inspired by Coraline. Honestly, beautiful piece. I love the texture. I love the use of movement within this piece. Overall, fantastic.
I'm Mallory Hopper, I'm the president of Environmental Club.
And I'm Sarah Slover.
And today we're going to be walking you through our hydroponics lab. Sarah?
Okay, so first over here we have our plant tower. Right now we're growing strawberries, and these are going to be harvested around Earth Week. So we have a bunch of special stuff coming up during that time. And then over here, which was the main bulk of the project, we have our raised waterbed for hydroponics. And the basis of how it works is just farming without soil. So the water's gonna go into this tub and then through some of these like pumping stuff, and then it'll go into the beds and go back into the system. So it's really cool. Yeah.
Another thing we have for you guys is our plant sale coming in April. That will be April 18th through the 22nd, and we'll be in the Learning Center before and after school just selling plants for you guys. And we're really looking forward to it, and it's gonna be super fun.
And then also on Earth Week, we have the 22nd, which is composting day. And we're going to be working with people from the school and composting our lunch food after.
Stay tuned, guys!
My name is Cooper Tinsley, and I am the current editor-in-chief of The Lantern.
Hi, I'm Ava Boedeker, and I'm the lead photographer of The Lantern this year.
My name is Delilah Flora. I'm the lead editor of the website and of graphic design on The Lantern.
I think The Lantern has grown into a tremendous program with multiple facets that includes many aspects of student life and culture. We act as a great repository for student voices.
I really love photography on The Lantern because it's a really good way to just kind of represent events through things other than writing. There's a little bit of writing that's associated with photography because we write captions describing photos, but I think that being able to portray events through media is really important. So if you're interested in photography, videography, media, anything like that, you should definitely apply.
I work on a lot of things on The Lantern. I help make the book of Verbatim, which has our poems, short stories, and a lot of fun, cool artwork made by our students here at WHS. And I also work on posting for the website. Even though I'm not involved directly with journalism, I get to see all the great work that all of our journalists do, and I get to see the news before anyone else does.
Hi, I'm Mr. Aiden, sponsor of The Lantern. The Lantern is a student-driven organization here at Westfield High School, and we are responsible for putting together a lot of different content and getting it out to you, the students, through our website, whsdigital.com. The Lantern class is a place to provide a lot of hands-on, real-world experience, especially if you are interested in any part of the communications world. So we are looking for writers, web designers, graphic designers, artists, photographers. We're looking for people who are interested in marketing. We're looking for people who are interested in social media, people who are interested in advertising. I think it's an opportunity for a class for you to really get a lot of, again, like real-world experience. That could be really valuable, even if you don't pursue communications-related fields. The skills that you're putting together in this classroom are definitely strong skills for business in the modern world.